Thank you. This morning's gospel that we're going to hear in a little bit, Jesus comes to the disciples through the midst of the storm and meets them on the boat that he's put them into. He meets them over the waters of the storm, and as we're going to hear when we read the gospel, their reaction is to worship him. So we are gathered together this morning to worship. And we begin worship with confession and forgiveness, which is found on the front of your bulletin. Please stand. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who greets us in this and in every season, whose word for us never fails, and whose promise to us is sure.
Amen.
Called together by the Holy Spirit and gathered in this place, let us confess our sin in the presence of God and our neighbors. Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned.
We have hurt our community. We have squandered your blessings. We have hoarded your bounty. In the name of Jesus, forgive us and grant us your mercy.
Righteous God,
we confess that we have sinned. We have failed to be honest. We have lacked the courage to speak. We have spoken falsely. In the name of Jesus, forgive us and grant us your mercy.
God is a cup of cold water when we thirst. God offers us boundless grace when we fail. So, called together by the Holy Spirit, claim the gift of God's great mercy. You are free and you are forgiven. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Merciful God, you are our defender. Gathered together in this place this morning, we admit to you that storms rage all around us and even within us. They cause us to be afraid. And so we ask that you would rescue us, your people, from our despair. We ask, gracious God, that you would deliver your sons and your daughters from our fear. And we ask that you would preserve us in the faith of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord. Amen.
Moses writes concerning the righteousness that comes from the law, and the person who does these things will live by it. But the righteousness that comes from faith says, do not say in your heart, who will ascend into heaven, that is, to bring Christ down, or who will descend into the abyss, that is, to bring Christ up from the dead. But what does it say? The word is near you, on your lips, and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart, and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth, and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame,
according to St. Matthew, the 14th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead to the other side of the Sea of Galilee while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But by this time, the boat, battered by the waves, was far from the land, for the wind was against them. And early in the morning, he came walking toward them on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat, started walking on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he noticed the strong wind, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "You of little faith, why did you doubt?" When they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshiped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Yeah. Relationships of people were in God. Confident that God receives our joys and concerns, let us offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation. God of grace and faith, your faithfulness is never ending, and your righteousness becomes ours through Jesus Christ. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of sky and sea, the plants, animals, mountains, and plains proclaim your glory. Prosper the work of ecologists as they teach us new ways to care for the environment. bring relief to areas recovering from natural disasters. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of peace and justice, you call us to live as your beloved community throughout the world.
Instilling political and civic leaders a desire to work for the well-being of all people.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of care and compassion, you bring assurance when we are afraid. Bring calm to any who are anxious or fearful. Comfort all who grieve and soothe any who are sick, especially William Christ, Katie, Tommy, Shelley, Betty Pam, Robin, Ted Jarmal, comfort for the Kohler family, and all those we hold in our hearts. Hear us, O God. God of wonder, you accompany us in both joys and sorrows. We pray for children and teachers preparing for the new school year.
Make your presence known in our work and play, in lively conversation, and in quiet rest.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of new life, you send people to renew both church and society.
We give you thanks for new lives of faithful service as examples of following your call.
Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Into your hands, O God, we commend all whom we pray. In the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Light of my soul, do
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcomes death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opens to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Gather together this morning with Bill Kohler and with all the saints in every time and in every place, we are bold to pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. This is the body of Christ. It's given for you. This is the body of Christ. It is given for you. This is the blood of Christ. Shed for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. Thank you. This is the